Hello there. Today we are going to talk a little bit about glasses prescriptions. Sometimes your eyes have different prescriptions. There's one in one eye and one in the other. Why is that? Let's go into some detail. So the chances are that if you've ever looked at your glasses or contacts prescription, you've noticed that you have a slightly different numbers for each eye. And in some cases, it's actually a pretty decent difference between each eye. Now, why would that be? Well, that all has to do with when we were babies. So when you're first born, your eye is only about 80% of the size that it's going to be. There's a myth that for some reason really, maybe I just hear about it because I'm in an eye clinic all day, but people will say that you are born with eyes that are the size that they will be when you're an adult. It's not accurate. It would look really incredible if you did. It'd look much more ET-like, but it's about 80%. And so that 80%, it's going to become 100% of what your eye will be. And so it grows as you grow. And so between ages 0 and about 18 years old, your eye is growing into about 100% of what the actual size is going to be. For about 95% of people, they're about 100% of the way to their full-grown eyeballs when they hit their 18th birthday. And so during that time, there's this rapid prescription change. Now, if you have ever looked really, really closely at a measurement of each of your feet, which who hasn't? Then you would probably find that you have maybe a half of a millimeter, maybe a millimeter of difference between each foot. You may be one of those people where you have the annoying problem of having to buy two pairs of shoes because you have one foot that's a size 8 and one foot that's a size 9. Everyone has slight amounts of asymmetry in their body on either side of their face, for either hand, for either feet. And that is there because these are one foot doesn't know what the other foot's doing as it grows. It has the same general DNA and instructions as it's going to grow and turn into different tarsal bones and toes, but it doesn't know what the other foot's doing. And so there's differences on a micro level, and we're talking really micro, the molecular level within your cells, in how rapidly they grow and in how quickly they change over time. And that leads to differences. So that's all well and good with feet. What about with eyes? Well, with eyes, that's the interesting part of this. Your eyeball, if you look at it from the side, it's kind of this round sphere here. And the front of it has that. That's what makes it spherical. And this thing right here is called your cornea. And this thing back here is called your retina. As light comes into your eye, it gets focused through your cornea and then gets turned inward like this. And that's what gives you an image as it comes in. There are two main features that determine what your prescription is. One is this cornea. How steep is this cornea? And the other one is this. How long is the eye from front to back? That's called the axial length. These two things determine almost entirely what your prescription is going to be. And the interesting thing about this is how tight the tolerances are for these things. So corneal steepness is measured in diopters, just like your pair of glasses are, and it's for the same reason. You measure a lens in diopters. A diopter of difference on your cornea will either make you a diopter more or less nearsighted. 1 millimeter of length of your eye added will make you 3 diopters more nearsighted. And then when you add in the fact that the cornea can be steep in different directions, if we're looking at the cornea from the front, it can either be really steep this way and real flat this way, or you can draw the same cornea and have it be really steep this way and really flat this way. Those are two different types of corneas. They might have the same overall curve, but they're very, very different depending on which way you're looking at it. And that's called astigmatism. When you combine all of those things, it makes for very, very, very small differences in anatomy that can lead to very noticeable differences in the prescription. That's why it's not at all unusual to have a diopter or two of difference between your glasses. It all happens as you go from the 80% of your total final eye size all the way to the 100%. The minor differences in development between those two lead to the differences in your prescription. I hope that helps. Bonus fun fact, when you are born, on average, your prescription is somewhere in the range of about plus 6 diopters. You're extremely farsighted as a baby, and it's because of that growth that will happen to your eye over time. The only way to end up at zero is to start off very farsighted, because as your eye gets longer, you're going to get less farsighted. And so a baby who's born with like roughly plus 3, they were farsighted but not enough, they'll end up kind of like I did, where I ended up at minus 3 because as my eye grew, I became nearsighted until I had LASIK. I hope that helps.